Hey, it's Sam, here again to tell you about my latest IT adventure. The whole thing started with an early Monday morning meeting with our CIO. Apparently, weekends are his blue sky thinking time, which means Monday mornings are usually more work for Sam time. Anyway, a few weeks ago, one of our biggest competitors suffered this big headline-making breach. Thousands of compromised identities, credit card numbers exposed, mass hysteria, the usual. The culprit? A bunch of weak usernames and passwords that got hacked. I think the whole incident hit a little too close to home, because in our meeting he's all, "Usernames and passwords are evil and must be destroyed. Exterminate, exterminate." Blue sky thinking strikes again, right? My basic response? Dear, meet headlights. But he definitely has a point. Usernames and passwords are a big-time security problem. And pretty much everyone agrees that multi-factor authentication is a safer way to give people access. But then, you have to worry about making sure everyone has a card reader or biometric scanner, constantly at the ready. And those things are not cheap. Plus, what about mobile workers and people outside the company who don't have the right reader? And how do you make all these different multi-factor technologies work together? A lot of really hard questions. And as it turns out, there are plenty of equally cool answers. Because when I looked into it, I found out that NetIQ has a solution that actually makes multi-factor authentication a viable option for our business. It's an advanced authentication framework that supports all the latest methods and technologies and gives us a ton of flexibility to manage our different authentication scenarios with a single set of unified policies. So with NetIQ, people in the office can scan their ID badges and enter a PIN to log in. People with biometric readers built into their laptops can use those to authenticate. And if someone forgets their ID badge, they can log in using a challenge and response as a plan B. We can even turn people's own smartphones into multi-factor authentication devices by sending one-time SMS passwords they can use to log in when they're on the go. That means everyone gets to use whatever authentication method makes the most sense, depending on where they're at and what they need access to. And as new technology becomes available down the road, we can just plug it into our existing framework and start using it. I'm actually meeting with our CIO later today to present this to him. He wants blue sky thinking? I'll show him blue sky thinking. Should be fun. So make sure you check out the Advanced Authentication Framework for yourself and find out how practical and easy it is to move beyond passwords with NetIQ.